In this video, we are going to create an expert advisor that is going to trade the parabolic SAR signal, and we are also using the Stochastics oscillator as a signal filter, so let's find out how to do that with MQL5. To get started, please click on the little button here or press F4 on your keyboard. Now you should see the MetaEditor window, and here we have a precoded version for this expert advisor. We start with an include statement. To import the file trade.mqh, this one comes with MQL5, and we will use it to open positions later on. Let's continue with two more include statements. The first one is for the check entry module for the parabolic SAR, that is this module here. And the second one is for the stochastic. We are going to use the stochastic as a filter. And now we want to calculate the ask price and the bid price. That is done by using symbol info double. For the current symbol on the chart, we use either symbol underscore ask or symbol underscore bid. And with normalized double and underscore digits, we make sure to calculate the right number of digits behind the dot. Let's continue and create an instance of the class CTrade. That will be called trade. In the onTick function, we use MQLRates to create an array called price info. With array set as series, we need to sort our price info array from the current candle downwards. And now we can use copy rates for the current symbol on the chart and the currently selected period. Starting from candle 0, for 3 candles, we want to store the data in our price info array. And that makes it possible to calculate the current price by looking at the close price for candle 0 in our price info array. Now let's define a trading signal and a filter. And to get the trading signal, we will call a function called checkEntrySAR. For the filter, it is called checkEntrySTochastic. And if our trading signal equals buy and the filter also equals buy, we want to check if positions total equals 0. That would be the case when we have no open positions. And when this is true and we have a buy signal, we want to use trade.buy to open a new buy trade for 10 microlot for the current symbol on the chart. In the other case, if the trading signal equals sell, and if the filter also says that we should sell, and if we have no open positions, we use trade.sell to sell 10 microlot. Finally, we use a comment statement to output the trading signal for the parabolic SAR and the filter for the stochastic on our chart. So far, so good. But to use this function, we need to create the second module. It is called checkEntrySAR. Before we can go to the second module, we need to cut out this part and use it here in the upper part as a global declaration. And the reason is we need the price info array also in our second module here. This one is called checkEntrySAR. So is the function here. And it will return a string value. Therefore, we define a string variable called signal here. We also need to define an array for our SAR signal. And now we can use the ISAR function that is included in MQL5 for the current symbol on the chart and the currently selected period on that chart. These are the standard values that you will see when you drag the parabolic SAR indicator on your chart. And now we use array set as series for our array to sort it from the current candle downwards. And with copy buffer, we can fill our SAR array according to the definition that we have created here. We do that for buffer 0, starting from the current candle 0 for 3 candles. And now we can calculate the last SAR value by looking into our SAR array. We do that for candle 1, and with normalized double and the value 5, we make sure that we create a value that has 5 digits behind the dot. For this video, I have out-commented the second part. That would make it possible to find crossover values. But for now, you can ignore that. For the buy signal, we want to check if the last SAR value was below the low price for candle 1 in our price info array. If that is true, we want to buy, so we assign the word buy to our signal. And for the sell signal, we want to check if the last SAR value was bigger than the high price for candle 1 in our price info array. And if that is true, we want to sell, so we assign the word sell to our signal. Finally, we return the signal to our main module by using the return statement here. Let's continue with the filter. The module and the function are called checkEntryStochastic. Here we also create a signal variable, and it is also a string value. Now we need two arrays, one for the K and one for the D array, because when you look at the stochastic, you will see two different lines here. Let's use array set as series to sort our K and our D array from the current candle downwards. And with iStochastic, for the current symbol on the chart and the currently selected period on the chart, we calculate the stochastic. For these three standard values, we use mode underscore SMA, that stands for mode simple moving average. And this is the last value here, STO low high. If you mark that and press F1, you will see that it is used for calculations based on high and low prices. And with copy buffer, we can fill our K array and our D array for buffer 0 or for buffer 1 from the current candle 0 for 3 candles. Now let's calculate the K value by looking into the K array, and we are interested in the value for candle 0. We do the same for the D value. And now we repeat that for candle 1, because that makes it possible to get a crossover. Because when K value 0 is below 20 and D value 0 is also below 20, and when K value 0 is bigger than D value 0 and K value 1 was below D value 1, that would mean we have a buy signal, and that's when we assign the word buy to our signal. In the other case, if K value 0 is bigger than 80 and D value 0 is also above 80, then we want to check if K value 0 is below D value 0 and if K value 1 was above D value 1. And if that is true, we want to sell, so we assign the word sell to our signal. Finally, we return our signal to the main module. And when you're done, please click on the main module and press F7 or click on the compile button. I don't see it right now, so let's enable the toolbar here. And here we have no errors, so the compilation has worked. If this was too fast for you, or if you have no idea what all the code here means, you maybe want to watch one of the other videos of the basic series first, or maybe even the premium course on our website might be interesting for you. We also have a store link there if you don't want to type everything yourself. You can get some source codes. But for now, we are done with compiling. So let's click on the little button here or press F4 to go back to MetaTrader. And in MetaTrader, you want to click on View, Strategy Tester, or press Ctrl and R. Please pick the new file, Standalone SAR Stochastic.ex5. Mark the option for the visual mode here and start your test. Here is our little expert advisor at work. It just said we have a buy signal, but the filter was not of the same opinion. So let's speed up the whole process a little bit. Here we are, the expert advisor is working. And in this little video, you have learned how to create an expert advisor that is able to use the parabolic SAR as a signal And we also combined it with a Stochastics filter, and you have coded it yourself with a few lines of MQL5 code.